Today, we discuss the bicycle. Now, we've got a lot of info to cover and no time to waste, so let's get to it. The bicycle is the first vehicle that most players will have access to. While the bicycle is a rudimentary form of transportation, it can be very beneficial in the early game of 7 Days to Die. So today, we're going to take a look at the bicycle. And let's start with the skills that govern the bicycle and how to craft it. The bicycle is governed by the Grease Monkey perk. This is located in the Intellect attribute. In order to unlock Grease Monkey level 1, you will need to get your intellect up to level 2, and then you can throw a point into bicycle mechanic. This opens up the ability to craft the bicycle parts and also allows you to craft wheels and bicycle parts 33% cheaper. Alternatively, you could find the bicycle chassis schematic or the bicycle handlebar schematic. However, a little known fact is you do not have to take either the perk or find either one of these schematics in order to build a bicycle. You can actually craft the finished vehicle without having to spend any skill points or find any schematics. Another interesting point is you do not need a workbench in order to craft the bicycle. The bicycle is the one vehicle that you can actually craft in your inventory. As long as you have the items on hand, you can go ahead and craft up a bicycle, no problem whatsoever. However, let's approach this like you actually do want to craft the individual pieces. If that's the case, you are going to need a bicycle chassis, and in order to craft that, you will need 7 forged iron, 3 mechanical parts, 3 duct tape, 3 leather, and 3 springs. Now this recipe does not take into account the 33% discount that you would get if you put a point into Grease Monkey. In order to craft the bicycle handlebars, you will need 3 duct tape, 3 leather, 1 mechanical part, 9 short iron pipes, and 3 springs. Now, one more item that you will need to craft in order to craft up your bicycle is wheels. You are going to need 2 wheels in order to craft up the bicycle. Now, in order to unlock wheel crafting, you need to either put a point into Grease Monkey or find any vehicle schematic. So if you found the bicycle chassis schematic or the bicycle handlebar schematic or any one of the other vehicle schematics, that will unlock the ability to craft wheels. And once you've unlocked that ability, you will need 3 forged iron, 24 scrap polymers, 2 oil, 15 coal, and 1 bottle of acid. Now, since you're going to need 2 wheels in order to craft a bicycle, you will need double these resources. This recipe is for 1 wheel. 1 wheel does you no good. You need at least 2. But once you have all of the items that you need, 2 wheels, 1 chassis, 1 handlebar, and 1 mechanical part, you can go ahead and craft up your bicycle. Once again, this can be done in your inventory. You do not need a workbench, and it takes 30 seconds in order to craft. So now that we have our bicycle crafted, let's go ahead and toss this bad boy down and take a closer look. All we'll do is go ahead and equip that bad boy. It's down there in our tool belt, and we will toss it down on the ground. Boop, there it is. Now let's go ahead and interact with the bicycle and take a closer look. When you open up the vehicle menu here, you learn a great many things. First of all, you have the durability rating. The bicycle has 1,500 hit points. We also learned that the top speed of the bicycle is 10 meters per second. It has a moderate noise level, a defensive rating of 90. It seats 1 person, but it does not require gasoline. That is one of the benefits of the bicycle. Instead of using gasoline to power this vehicle, you actually just use your stamina bar. And we'll demonstrate that here in a little bit. Another great feature of the bicycle is its storage capacity. So you can open up its storage here, and you'll notice that you do gain a little bit of storage with the bicycle. It's not much, but honestly, any extra storage is better than no extra storage. So now let's go ahead and hop on our bicycle and go for a little bike ride. So here I am just riding the bicycle down the road. You do move a little bit faster on the bicycle than you do on your feet. And if you hold down the turbo button, you go even faster. However, that does use your stamina bar. So unfortunately, your stamina bar will eventually run out. And once it does, you will head back down to the regular speed for the bicycle until your stamina bar regains a little bit of steam. Then you can bump it up into turbo again and start moving even faster. Now, for all of my controller users out there, Alpha 19.4 did offer some changes to the gamepad. Now, in order to control the bicycle itself, you will use the left joystick and only the left joystick. The right joystick will move the camera. So as you see, I'm going straight and the camera is moving around, but only the left joystick will move the actual bicycle itself. So that is an important change. And for all of my mouse and keyboard users out there, the W key will move your bicycle forward, and moving the mouse is how you actually steer the bicycle. So I move the mouse to the right and boop, my bicycle turns to the right. I move the mouse to the left and the bicycle turns to the left. Now, if you hold down the shift key when you are on your mouse and keyboard, that will enter in the turbo, the boost mode for the bicycle. And for you controller users out there, you have to click the left thumbstick in order to enter turbo mode. So once again, the W key on the keyboard will go forward and the S key on the keyboard will go backwards. Once again, move your mouse right or left in order to turn the bicycle, and hit that shift button in order to enter the turbo mode. For controller, the right trigger will move your guy forward. The left trigger will move the bicycle backwards. You'll use the left joystick in order to turn the vehicle, and click the left joystick in order to enter turbo mode. Now, the bicycle isn't the most fancy form of transportation in 7 Days to Die. However, in the early game, it can be a huge benefit. It allows you to get to quest POIs or certain locations you have your eye on a lot faster than by simply running. Plus, it offers you a little bit of extra storage, which is always nice. So all in all, the bicycle is an excellent starter vehicle in 7 Days to Die. Now, if you'd like to see some more awesome 7 Days to Die tutorials, I've created a very special playlist that you can access by clicking the box in the top right corner of the screen. But for now, this is Savin saying thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me in Savin's World. And remember, the average gamer is always king of the hill on the bell curve.